Thanks, little guy.
Ding-ding.
Oh, thank you.
Ding-ding.
Did I miss something? When did we get to Disneyland?
Ding-ding.
Good morning, everybody in YouTube land. This is Stephanie Janicek, your friendly neighborhood buyer manager, Wookie Wrangler, Chaos Coordinator, bringer of news. It has been reported yesterday by Reuters, and I'll leave a link in a pinned comment, that the president of Disney Parks West, Catherine Powell, has left the company. It's funny how quickly news spread around, because if you go to Wikipedia, that part of her life, president of Disney Parks West, is already past tense. That's how fast this happened. She was the one who basically oversaw Disneyland and Disney World. She was the president of Euro Disney in Paris one time. The woman is British. And we all know the trouble they've had with the park attendance being down. And let me explain why this is an interesting little observation. Disney is such a big company, can probably swallow the losses of Solo between, I would say, $100 million and $200 million, depending on the math you use. Catastrophic loss. They can swallow even the fact that other movies aren't doing as well. The fact that they are under SEC, Securities and Exchange Commission investigation because of whistleblowing, tampering with box office numbers is very interesting. I want you to keep your eyes on that one. That could come back and bite Bob Iger in the ass. Okay? This is very interesting. Now, as you know, but Disney, can it swallow catastrophic film losses? Plus, merchandise sales being so low. Just because Captain Marvel's selling doesn't mean Star Wars is. And Star Wars, by rule, should be kicking Marvel's ass, okay? But they're not. Can they swallow, and the biggest, most important thing, sorry for the cough. Can they deal with those two things, plus park attendance being so low and Galaxy's Edge being an utter flop? No, I have friends who loved going there, but for the most part, reviews have been mediocre to, all right, we're going to go with basically a consensus review here that Galaxy's Edge is a waste of money, okay? Despite some good reviews but from friends. So what does it mean? Well, let's go back to something I reported. Oh, not too long ago, Bob Iger was approached by Paramount and Universal to buy lock, stock, and barrel everything at Lucasfilm. Just remove it from Disney. But there were stipulations. Kennedy's contract had to be bought out. Everything Disney did would be decanonized. They couldn't use any of it anymore. And the EU had to go with them. Here's the reason. If you're a company and you're looking to add to your weaponry, okay, and you see something sitting on the shelf like, all right, granted, there are bad storylines in the EU. Mara Jade being married to Luke. That is just, if George Lucas didn't like that line, storyline, I agree with him. And there are some other things, but there's a wealth of information there. There's a wealth of storytelling that has real value to it, that if it's used properly, you could actually probably make some great movies, streaming content for your streaming channel or for feature films, okay? So they saw value in the EU, that's why they wanted it. Unlike Lucasfilm and Disney, the moment Disney bought it, they shit-canned the EU in its entirety, which is, you know, there are ways of doing this without, there are ways of utilizing what was there without using the whole thing. Either, it's not an either or, okay? You either use it or you don't, okay? And The fact that they're cherry-picking stuff out of the EU to me is now fascinating. Anyway, let's talk a little bit more. Bob Iger flat-out refused him. Flat-out refused him. Okay, so I'm going to read you who these guys are. So after Iger kind of dissed the offer, a member of the board, Christine McCarthy, another member, Alan Braverman, and the man who's the highest stockholder among the shareholders, voting shareholders, Robert Matchelet, basically began a movement to oust Iger. Here's the deal. Before Paramount and Universal made the offer to Iger, they went to George Lucas, who was very much for it. Let me explain something, because a lot of people don't like the idea of Star Wars going to Paramount. Here's the thing. Paramount and Steven Spielberg have a really good relationship. Remember, Raiders of the Lost Ark. Okay. I think with that would probably be a decent place for the feature films. And Universal Parks are getting rave reviews right now. It would be a great thing. And of course, we also haven't said this yet, but George Lucas owns quite a bit of stock. In fact, the part of the deal when he sold out to Disney was stock voting shares. Okay. Then Iger's book gets released. And there's an excerpt, and I'm sure everybody's been talking about it, how he basically admitted that, you know, George Lucas doesn't like what they've done with Star Wars. Well, no one who's a Star Wars fan can say they like it. I know some people do, and that's fine. But they've lost control of it, all right? We've, you know, when you farm out your PR to Star Wars Explained, making StarWars.net steal Saunders, who are gatekeeping fans, who basically enable Raylos, and Raylos not going to happen, but it's like, that's not your fan base. And in fact, these unaffiliated, unofficial sites do more damage to Lucasfilm and Star Wars than, you know what I'm saying? So, okay. What's going on here? All right. There's a lot going on. Catherine Powell, you know, did she resign or was she fired? Probably she was fired. I mean, look at the horrific, financials coming out of the parks themselves in the U.S. Now, here's the thing. Here's another thing. Bob Iger still insists that Star Wars fatigue. It's not, you know, they can say, you know, well, you know, Solo didn't do so well because people were so upset about The Last Jedi. If The Last Jedi had actually made sense in the Star Wars, in the saga, and actually continued the story J.J. started, and in a way it kind of does, and in lots of ways it doesn't. I mean, depending on how you watch the movie. And, you know, you shouldn't have to have a film degree to watch a movie, a Star Wars movie. It's just, you know, two different fan groups. And the fan group you don't want to cater to, that doesn't buy the merchandise, that doesn't go to the movies over and over again, got catered to. Okay. The vision was completely different than JJ's. Not that I'm a huge fan of JJ, but I kind of see him as someone who means well. You don't see him standing around with little signs, you know, Steel Saunders stickers, saying with a smug, condescending, stupid look on his face, "Your snook theory sucks." I mean, you just don't do that. But, okay. So you don't see him doing that. But, you know, it's not just a TLJ backlash. Solo, in some people's minds, was fine. I don't know why. Alden Ehrenreich is atrocious. You know, I'll say it again. I'll say it over and over again. Alden Ehrenreich, in 1974-75, when Lucas was interviewing people and auditioning people, would not have made it past headshot and resume. He just wouldn't have. I mean, the last guy on the planet. I've explained why. There's a certain type of actor you want to play Han Solo, and Ehrenreich doesn't fit any of those characters. Maybe as a sidekick to the sidekick, but that's about it, okay? Any of those actors at all. He literally is the anti Harrison Ford. The 180 opposite of Harrison Ford. And the fact that, you know, they wimped him up so that, oh God, I can't stand Emilia Clarke. Every time I see her, she just makes me want to vomit. I don't get it. So her character, Queera, gets the, you know, the kudos. It's a Han Solo movie. It's not girl power. Shut the fuck up. Sorry for swearing. Okay. Anyway, let's come back. It was a bad movie. All right. It would not have made the money that Rogue One made because it was a bad movie. I mean, when John Kasdan announces kind of out there that he wasn't sure he wanted to do it, it says something. If your heart's not into something and you're creating something, a work of art, don't do it. You know, it's got to come from your gut. It's got to come from your heart. It's got to come from your soul, not from a paycheck and a contract. I mean, then, you know, the movie was phoned in. It was, there's a ton of virtue signaling in it. It was just a catastrophe. Ehrenreich couldn't stay in character. You know, he was laughable. It was like watching a really bad cosplayer. You know, but Iger wants to blame Star Wars fatigue. No, I absolutely would not have fatigue. No one would if it was good. Okay. But it's not. So quit lying to us. Quit using that. I mean, Bob, you're gaslighting people. Fucking stop it. We know why it didn't work. What you're doing is wrong when it comes to Star Wars. Okay? The Force is female. No, the Force, it has no gender. It's neither male nor female, you moron. All right? What did you do? Use a marketing ploy in a take polls to see what would work. And then you didn't even poll the right groups. You know, the Force... That's just the tip of the iceberg, okay? You've got Lucasfilm employees badgering and attacking fans for not liking what they're doing. Thin-skinned much? Okay? Calling people man-babies as Ryan Johnson, mental midgets Pablo, basically demonizing people because they don't like their product. That's another problem. It has nothing to do with Star Wars fatigue. And I'm going to leave you with this. Bob Iger's in trouble. Okay. He's in a lot of trouble. The shareholders are watching the stock go down. I've got a friend, reviews for you, Craig, who's got 10,000 shares. He's a voting shareholder and he is pissed. That's a lot of money going down the tube. Okay. A lot. People are losing, you know, if a stock drops 2%, that's billions of dollars, okay? This is where the problem is for Iger. You've got Robert Matchellet leading the charge to remove him because he wouldn't take that Paramount Universal offer. Probably being allying, and Matchellet's probably allying with George Lucas himself. When I looked at that thing in the book about Lucas that Iger put in there, it's like, you know, first off, he's shrewder than you are, Bob. Second of all, you did betray him. You did lie to him, okay? You can sit there and say you didn't. And people can say, no, Lucas has been... No, it's not true. I do know for a fact that the reason why they didn't use any of the OT characters as much as they could have and didn't respect him was because they didn't want to pay George Lucas the 25% because he still owned that 25%. Okay. I also know that Lucas did have a certain yes or no over things, and he didn't want to exercise it till after Solo went up and crashed down to the Earth's crust and the molten hot lava in the center of the Earth. Okay. He didn't exercise that. Now he is. Now, he's basically overseeing the entire production of the Rise of Skywalker. I don't know what the novel, what Iger's biography means to what's going to happen at the Rise of Skywalker's box office. I suspect because Lucas is finally involved, he was the one that ordered the reshoots last April. They're going on into October, all right? Is this normal? No and yes. I do know movies get edited right up until the time they're released. Okay. So I don't know. However, Lucas pretty much can go anywhere he wants. If you look at the IMDb page for The Mandalorian, you see Jon Favreau writer, George Lucas writer. Okay. He can walk in and do anything he wants right now at Lucasfilm. There's a lot of stuff going on there too. And Iger, like I said, is in trouble. So we'll see. Do I think that the Disney board can fix what's broken? Well, a friend of mine, Craig at Reviews for You, likes to say that Disney's too big to fail, and they'll figure out some way to keep Lucasfilm. My thing is, if the shareholders are angry enough, they'll take that offer. They'll dump Iger and take that offer. And one of my favorite parts of this whole offer was this: paying Kennedy off her contract completely. You know what that means? Bye. That's what that means. All right. Iger's in trouble. Iger did not know what he was doing when he got a hold of Lucasfilm. It shows. It is sad. It is sad this has gone, this has happened. I feel sorry, not for him, I feel sorry for George Lucas. All right, he trusted him. And remember, you know, the white slavers coming, that came back to haunt us. That's come back to haunt Iger, all right? Because now it's gotten real. There's an offer on the table, he said no, and now he's reaping the whirlwind for it. And this Catherine Powell leaving Disney Parks West is probably the tip of the iceberg of what might be happening. Okay, so if you're Disney, if you're a voting shareholder and you're pissed off about what's going on and you're mad at Iger and it comes up that you want him removed, vote to remove him. Okay, you'll be doing everybody and Star Wars a favor if you do. So this is Steph signing out. See you around the galaxy. See you around the cantina. Please remember to tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos, no Ray nobodies, no Ray Palpatines, no Ray Luke's clone hand, no Ray Luke clone of, or no Ray clone of Leia, no Ray nobody, Ray random, whatever. Fist fights, take it out in the alley. Gunfights, you take this shit out in the street. See you around the galaxy.